This is my very first CO2 laser, the Monport Onyx 55W. And I've used diode lasers before, but this is a whole different level. From autofocus to serious engraving power, here are my first impressions and the projects I've already started with it. Now, right off the gate, this does ship with RD Works, but I've completely ignored that because it wasn't really Mac compatible. So I went with Lightburn, which is pretty much the only thing anybody recommends on Reddit to use. Now, the only downside to all of this is that there is no material library included. Thankfully, I was able to reach out to Monport to get some sort of material library, and that's helped, but it's still not very in-depth. Now, setting up the camera on this was quite a bit of a learning curve, and to be honest with you, it's still not even perfect. It's close enough for most things, I think, but I would like to get it to where it's a lot better. I just need to really tinker with it to kind of get it to that point. It's definitely has not been easy. Thanks to a couple videos that I did find on YouTube, Louisiana laser guy. If I can remember it, I'll put it up here on the screen. He showed me that you can adjust the XY shift just in the software to kind of help compensate for any of the camera calibration. Now, one thing I completely didn't even notice is that the included USB key actually has some pre-calibrated settings for Lightburn for the camera on this. So definitely start with that. Don't be like me and completely ignore that that even existed. Now, I do have a small gripe. The included USB cables are great, albeit there's one issue. This one is doubled up and it's super long. It's perfect. It's a great length. But the other one that they give you, which is a U-Green USB cable, I thought was pretty interesting, is so tiny. It's so short. Why give such a long cord on this one and a short cord on this one? I'd like to see that fixed. Now, like I mentioned before, this is a 55W CO2 laser, and I think that's decently powerful, right? I mean, I've only used diode lasers before, so I'm not entirely sure how powerful this is in the realm of laser powering, stuff like that. I do know that it has a pretty large work area. Inside here, we've got an 18.5 by 11.5 inch work area, which is actually really nice, but the machine is so big. That's the one thing I don't like about it, is that this machine is huge and I already don't have enough room in my garage, and this doesn't help. But on the plus side, you do have that big work area. One other nice feature about this laser is the fact that it does have autofocus and it works pretty well. I know I have seen some videos on some other lasers where you have to like manually adjust the autofocus, and I don't have time for that. I want autofocus, especially in today's day and age. Now, this is rated for going like 500 millimeters per second in terms of like acceleration speed. I haven't really tested that. It's still really quick as it is. If I had a better material library, I could really get a better idea of how fast this machine is in terms of everything. This does seem faster than some of the diode lasers that I've used in the past, so that is good. In addition to those two USB ports that are on the back for your camera and for your control of the machine, you do have an Ethernet port. And looking at the spec page, this thing is supposed to have Wi-Fi, but I have no idea how to set that up. That is definitely something I need to figure out because I'm tired of plugging in USB cables on a MacBook that requires a dongle, because USB-A to USB-A, there's none of those on this. Now, I will say this, this shipped beautifully. It came in this massive crate and it actually arrived in really good condition. So they really know how to pack this thing to make sure it gets to its destination without getting damaged. That is a really nice plus to see. Now, when Monport reached out to send me this, I did request that they give me the fume extractor as well because, well, I'm in a garage that's typically closed up, so having somewhere to just kind of send all those fumes is kind of necessary for me. And it's going to be nice if I can move this away from the garage entrance. I can get it to a spot where it doesn't require to have the fumes go somewhere. It can just go into the extractor. It's really nice, but there is a big price difference between the machine stock versus with the fume extractor. The machine stock is about $1,699, whereas if you get the extractor with it, it's $2,069. So it is a bit more, but I think it's worth it. Now, I have made some projects with this already. I made some custom SIM caps for a local bike shop of mine that are my friends. I've made some for them before, and it was definitely a learning process to try to figure out how to get that camera to work properly, because trying to get this thing lined up was horrible. I wasted so many of these. I actually got smart. I cut some out of wood that was the right size, and was actually testing on this to get it as close as I could before actually using my proper stem caps. One thing I do plan on doing with this as well is making some custom hats for that bike shop and maybe some custom hats for myself. It's this can cut leather pretty easily and engrave leather. So I like doing those little leather embossed hats. I think those look really cool. Now, when I was engraving the stem caps, I had previously made this 3D printed little jig to kind of help line up everything easily. Now, unfortunately, I learned the hard way that this laser, not being a diode laser, can actually cut through my jig here, and it burned it all and even straight through. So you can actually see the infill on here. So that is something to note, is that, you know, these 3D printed jigs may not last in a laser like this. Now let me know in the future, do you want to see some content on where I explore trying to engrave 3D prints with this laser? I think that could be kind of cool. Let me know down in the comments below. So I played around with the wood a little bit and I got this. Some cool engravings, but nothing deep enough to cut, which is something I'm definitely learning on, trying to get the right settings to figure out on each particular wood, because not all the woods are the same. Trying to get it to engrave all the way through is a learning curve at that. Now, for instance, on this wood, same thing. I tried to do some bookmarks. It didn't quite cut all the way through. It looks cool, but it's not a bookmark because it's not cut out of this wood, but that's my fault. This isn't the machine's fault. This is me learning how much power I need to give this thing and how fast it needs to go. If anyone knows of a material library available for a laser like this, please let me know down in the comments below. You'd be a lifesaver. I did manage to get one out that I had to break, actually, because it didn't fully go, but it looks cool. The laser burns is definitely not great. I have seen some people talk about where you can use a magic marker to kind of get rid of the black soot. So that could be a good idea to clean this up, but I still think it looks kind of cool. I have played around doing like these little acrylic earrings. Let's see, a little, I haven't removed the tape on this, but the little skull guy, a bigger skull guy. Here's one that's actually like taken off so you can see. Now, one that is really intricate is this rose that I did. This came out really good and the detail on this is fantastic. Next time I should probably remove that paper backing before actually, you know, lasering these to cut these out, because trying to get this off is not easy. Here is a quick little engraving that I did and cut. I think this turned out okay. The engraving could definitely be better. This is not your typical wood. I think this is walnut, so it's a little bit harder to cut and engrave versus the regular, like, lighter plywood. Here is a failed stem cap that I had done. But, you know, it's the learning curve, trying to figure out the settings to get the best detail possible. So there you have it. This is the Monport Onyx 55W laser cutter, and it's pretty cool. I need to use this some more before I can really get a deep dive on anything. I'm not much of a laser guy. I do mostly 3D printing on this channel, but I'm always intrigued by new technologies and this showed up and I couldn't help myself. Plus, I'm gonna make some really cool hats. Now, if you thought this fume extractor thing was pretty cool, I'm actually thinking about hooking this up to one of my 3D printers, but I have done something similar in this video right here that you should probably check out.